Sarah Musa.
When I said I would take over the media, that was me last year. But I still like, I do want to make my difference and my mark in it. Thank you, first of all, for doing an event like this and letting me know and helping me.
It's very confusing for people to block for me and mom's face to be moderating and stuff, so it's all good.
Before I start doing any poems, I want to, like, a lot of the panelists talk about making media as your career. I think if you're really passionate about something and you really love it and you just want to do it, there will be so many things, so many opportunities that are presented to you that you will never ever think could have been possible. I know for me the past year, too many great things have happened to me. I never would have imagined that it would. And so, like, a lot of things that I'd like to tell people, if you have something that you want to do, please do it. Because you have a voice, and you can't trust anybody else to speak it for you. You have something to say, you have to say it yourself. So that's just my opinion. So I'm going to do a poem I haven't done in a while. It's called How to Be a Perfect Lady. Well, you know, society tells us that this is how it's supposed to be, so you really just have to ignore that and create your own image of what you want to be. How to be a perfect lady. Edition 2. Descend from your bed with your hair strands in place. Let it flow in the wind like a beautiful mirage. It's all about creating the illusion of sophistication. Your teeth must be straight. They shall gleam like diamonds. Pack your face with all the dishonesty you are trying to cover up. Put lipstick on your mountain lips. Make sure it doesn't go over the edges. It has to be perfect, like CoverGirl. Maybe Calvin Klein will want you then. Put your right hand on your hip and switch like a runaway model walking towards her master puppeteer who throws lashes on her back using bright lights that drill into her skin like she were a barrel of oil. He's hit the jackpot. Convincing her that she needs to be more desirable Hollywood starlet type because artists are supposed to sketch her out. Songs were meant to be written about her. Movie characters are supposed to be inspired by her. She's gotta have a legacy that is to be remembered. Sort of like Marilyn Monroe, an icon. Perfect ladies in training, we are not done yet. Attaining perfection and looking glamorous takes plenty of time, and you want to be up there, don't you? You have to be willing to sacrifice a lot of time, money, energy, and even your personality, but hey, you'll be perfect. You'll have everything you've ever wanted, and because you're perfect, you'll be able to wrap all that the world has to offer on those tiny pearls of greed resting over your longing heart. Why look so sad, darling? Is this not what you wanted? I feel everybody's receptive energy, so let's go with it. Another poem. This one is like, I call it Seasons of Change, because, you know, we're always going through change, and sometimes we resist it, but I learned that when you're resisting something new in your life, it doesn't go so well. You have to just go with it and let things be, because you never know what the possibilities are. There's something about this time of year that makes me nostalgic. The sound of lies unfolding before my eyes divulges my reality. The warm weather causes us to shed a little and be more bare. Maybe that's why they call it the naked truth. I felt longing fluttering in my stomach like a ballerina. My nerves were doing the Lindy Hop. trying to shape me, make me feel emotions that make me uncomfortable, stripping away any confidence I had, laying vulnerability out in the open. My heart thumped swiftly at the thought of something new, getting older, being even more responsible. There's something beautiful about the seasons of change that brings dramatic transformations in people. Sometimes it feels like grenades are going off in my chest, and my tongue is wired to my teeth to prevent secrets from pouring out of my soul, the same ones I wish to tell you. Self-consciousness wraps my body in electrical wires, and even that's not enough to contain me. Sometimes, I don't know myself, but now I'm okay with it. I heard that people go to different places to find themselves, embark in different spiritual journeys. Maybe that's what life is, one really big spiritual journey. Neruda says that one day you will find yourself, and that could be your most happy or bitter moment of your life, and indeed that can be the case. But life was never meant to come easy. There will be plenty of roadblocks, and it's up to you to navigate through them swiftly. And never, ever, ever use your fear of failing as a scapegoat for abandoning your dreams. If you do, ask yourself, did I want it bad enough in the first place? Did I deserve it? Shameless plug. How many of you guys have heard of the Voices of Venus series?
Yeah.
I'm actually fortunate to be featured there in 2 weeks. So Tuesday, August 9th at 7 o'clock at Umi Cafe. I have a 40-plus minute set. So, you know, if you want to come and you really like what I'm doing, please come out. I'm going to do a lot of different things. Just really explore and branch out.
Sorry, was that Voices of Venus?
Yeah, Voices of Venus.
It specializes in the spoken word scene is diverse, but it is often very male dominated. So Voices of Venus is emphasizing on the great female spoken word arts we have here.
So last poem. Inscriptions on paper. We let the ink ooze from the pen that desires to be a carbon copy of God's own. The seeds of imagination that was planted deep in our brain waves, we set our souls free and bear them. Every time we step on stages, we scramble to find pieces of ourselves and clumsily glue them back together. We pour our hearts into the letters that we write to loved ones. We stare in astonishment at the cosmos, hoping that each spectacle has our names engraved in it with the brightest of atoms, and when clouds hang over your head like wallpaper. And the taste in your mouth is a yellow sort of bitterness. And you feel in your heart a blue sort of anger that trickles into your exploding veins and beats resentment and pain into your body. Remember the times you stood on mountaintops with your palms faced up towards the sky like a peace offering to God. How submission felt so good, so right. Like peace wasn't just a greeting but a word that housed in your heart. Remember that you're not alone. Remember the times you used to beg God for his forgiveness and how you longed for him to relieve you of your heartaches. Instead, you turned to the pen. Never gave any credit to God, for he was the one that gave you this gift, yet you acted like the pen and paper were your savior. Started to change intentions and felt like you were fighting a bloody battle between your ego and your humility. Remember that you have several backs offering themselves to you as stepping stones. You wanted to be a gleaming rock star, but were chosen to be a rising leader, activist, and modern-day scholar. Your destination was already written in the books. And sometimes the devil's whisper can sound so melodic, sort of like a harp, but you need to understand that God is that golden, peaceful light that smiles at you every time, and he will always be there. Thank you very much.